Here we are once again, another Telecaster. Let's play a game of what's wrong and what's right. First, we'll check the relief of the neck. And I would call that right. Okay, next. Oh, this is ugly.
We're just down here looking at the fret munch. Right? Can't have that. Makes your chords sound sour when you're playing against other guitars in a band. Might be okay in your basement, but that's why a really good band sound really in tune. Because all the guitars don't have that. Okay, one thing was, what's right and what's wrong? One right, one wrong. Just for fun, first fret action is squeaky clean. Okay, this will be in the what's wrong category. The saddles shouldn't all be tippy like that. They can be different heights, but they should be perpendicular to this. It's like having half your tire on the road and half of it isn't.
Well, we'll just look at some pickup height and buzzer way too close to the strings. Like just stupidly close. The bridge pickup almost cuts it, but no, this isn't working right. What about the treble? The terrible side. Same thing, buzzer, and this is a sort of buzzer. So there we are. We're gonna get the neck off of it and get rid of all the munch.
It has the tilt-a-wheel function, which I don't like to use unless you need to, and only then in tiny amounts.
But first, excuse me while we have a session of removing the goo out of the set screws. Someone says use air. Well, you can, but this is like putty in there. We'll get to the air part. And I'm not buying a compressor for three square. I have one, but I'm not lighting it up for that much air. Okay, let's just see if the wrench machine actually makes these turn or if they're all screwed up. Well, that's a good sign. Those are the ones I was really worried about. Anyway, oh, there's one. A little froze. Put a little more Earl in that one. There comes the goo. Oh my goodness. Just corroded. She's a corroded. You know, this is all the fun stuff, right? It's supposed to be an easy setup. Man, there's so much crud on there, I have to wipe it off the wrench. But hey, guys, this is all the fun, right? Remember, Dave's World of Fun Stuff? Let's just get the saddles level before I put this on the shelf. That's fairly sort of okay. I never did measure the string action, but I could tell by looking at it, it was just whacked. There's another one that's stuck. Don't be that guy. It's all filled with goo. Human goo.
Okay, we'll do a little before and after regurgitation here. Time-lapse photography.
There's the after shot.
Let's put it back together and make it go.
Yes, and that question, what do you use to clean a maple fingerboard that's covered in a coat of stuff. That's what I use. If it's grimier than that, well, when we get out the Simple Green, but that's usually disinfectant time. That's just getting beyond cleaning at that point. Okay, put her back together. Okay, we got strings on it. She's tuned up the bitch. Let's see what Mr. Trussrod has to say. And I can totally roll with that. No more, no less. It's a string height. Yeah, my biggest foe here is the gummed up set screws. And as I mentioned before, I don't like to use the tilt function. And there's really no need to. And you can set things up really high and then tilt it into position, and you can dick around with the tilt and change the string action without having to do what I'm doing here, right? Technically, that's the idea. But, anyway, yeah. Tilt or no tilt? That is the question. I'll let you guys decide. That one's good. A string's a little high. Like I said, once again, making sure they're not all cocked over to one side, that they're all sort of even with the guitar. I'm singing a freaking song. This could be Peterson the movie. It works better. Plug it in. So when it stops, we love it. And someone was giving me the gears about not checking it in playing position. Balderdash. And you can see, she's a little sharp. Let me check it in playing position. Still sharp. Right? Like, you get the idea. Was left the old pickup height, which remember from previous episodes was Dick. It's like they can't have that. There's no way this thing sounded any good at all. Watch, now it's going to fall into the guitar when I lower it where it needs to be. There we go. And let's just get this guy while we're here. Once again, way too close to the strings. So when the string's vibrating, it doesn't have enough opportunity to create its greatest amplitude across the magnet. And what's going on is you might think you're making it better, but you're choking your sound. Why doesn't that guy want to go down where it needs to? You see, this is what you get into, right? All that surgical tube inside is probably old and rotten.